Hello friends, welcome to our channel Community Medicine Made Easy. Today we are going to see about RCH program. When it comes to RCH program, it is divided into three phases: phase 1, phase 2 and phase 3. What I am going to do is, I am going to make this program very simple for you to understand. After understanding about the program, I will tell the key points which should be written in your answer paper. I will just tell the main points that should be in your paper within a few minutes. So before you get into the video, please put a like button below this video, and if you find my video useful, please subscribe my channel Community Medicine Made Easy. So RCH program mainly has three phases: phase 1, phase 2 and phase 3. Phase 1 was started in the year 1997. What are the main components covered? It is child survival and safe motherhood, reproductive tract infections and sexually transmitted diseases, and family planning. These are the main areas covered under phase 1. There were so many drawbacks and so many gaps in the implementation of the program. So considering the gaps in the phase 1, RCH phase 2 was implemented in the year 2005. Only thing is, here the strategies were improvised. Means whatever the strategies that were there in the phase 1, that were improvised in phase 2. But phase 3 is a paradigm shift in the implementation of the program. Phase 3 was implemented in the year 2013. In phase 3, the newborn child was taken as the center, and all the different strategies of RCH phase 1 and phase 2 are integrated and linked in this phase 3. So the integration and linkage was happening in phase 3. In addition to that, various indicators were devised to monitor the strategies, and more technology and tools were used in this phase 3. So in phase 3, it is mainly the linkage and integration. In addition to that, they used various tools for monitoring by using indicators. So this is the comprehensive framework about RCH program. Now we will get into the details about what are the important points that should be there in your answer. First, we will start with RCH phase 1, which was started in the year 1997. What are the strategies provided under the RCH phase 1? Essential obstetric care, emergency obstetric care, 24-hour delivery services, Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act implementation, control of reproductive tract infection and sexually transmitted diseases, immunization under Universal Immunization Program in 1992, RCH, ORS and zinc, acute respiratory diseases control, prevention and control of vitamin A deficiency in children, like you giving 1 lakh units. The second component is the focusing mainly on EAG states. In phase 1, in RCH phase 1, the empowered action group states were given more importance. So what are those empowered action group states? They come under BMRU. That is, the population growth is going to increase majorly. That is, 53% of the population growth in our country will happen in these 7 states. That's why it is called EAG states, empowered action group states. So what are the 7 states? You can remember this mnemonic: BMRU, JOC, BI for Bihar, MA for Madhya Pradesh, R for Rajasthan, U for Uttar Pradesh, J for Jharkhand, O for Odisha and C for Chhattisgarh. In RCH phase 2, from the previous experiences and studies, the strategies were refined. Under the essential obstetric care, institutional delivery was given more importance, and a basic essential obstetric services, instead of giving cash for the workers, appointing 3 or more staff is more useful. This is what the experience from Tamil Nadu has showed. So appointing more staff is given more importance, more ANMs, more ASHAs, and emergency obstetric care was given importance by ensuring skilled attendants at birth, strengthening the first referral units and ensuring the availability of surgical facility in first referral unit, newborn care in first referral unit, 24-hour blood storage facility in first referral unit. So the first referral unit was given a proper definition only under the RCH phase 2. Then Janani Suraksha Yojana was implemented in the year 2005 under RCH phase 2. The main goal is motivating people to utilize the government facility for delivery, antenatal, postnatal and child care services. It is a 100% centrally sponsored scheme. One Day Modern scheme was introduced to utilize the private clinics for delivery of MCH services.
safe abortion services was given importance, that is standardizing the abortion service by giving mifepristone followed by misoprostol if the pregnancy is less than 7 weeks of amenorrhea, and manual vacuum aspiration if more than 7 weeks of amenorrhea. Then village and health and nutrition day, maternal death review and pregnancy tracking were introduced under Janani Suraksha Yojana. Then Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyakram was introduced in the year 2011. Under this scheme, free diet was given up to 3 to 7 days after delivery. Free diagnostic facilities, free blood transfusion facilities were given. Then nutrition and rehabilitation centers for severe acute malnutrition was established. So in these centers, if the baby is brought with severe acute malnutrition, then the baby will be admitted. First in stabilization phase, IV fluids will be given. Then in transition phase, oral fluids will be given. And in rehabilitation phase, appropriate nutritional therapy will be given. Micronutrient supplementation, vitamin A, multivitamin, folic acid, zinc, copper, iron, and follow-up of the discharged children will also be done from these centers. Then integrated management of neonatal and childhood illness was introduced under RCH phase 2. Then facility based newborn care was given more importance, that is newborn care corner, newborn stabilization units, special newborn care units, triage of 6 newborns were all introduced under the RCH phase 2. The last component of RCH phase 2 is Rashtriya Bal Swasthya Karyakram, introduced in 2013. Under this scheme, birth defects of the children, the developmental problems of the children were given more importance. You can remember with the help of 4D, that is defects at birth, diseases in children, deficiency conditions, developmental delays including disabilities, and then facility based newborn screening, community based newborn screening, screening children 6 weeks to 6 years, screening children in the government and government aided schools. So that's all about phase 2. RCH phase 3 introduced in 2013. What is the background of this phase 3? In 2012, Global Child Survival Call to Action, a promise to keep, a global conference was organized in Washington DC, attended by 80 countries across the world, with only one goal, that is to reduce the infant mortality to less than 20 per thousand by the year 2035. So in February 2013, Government of India launched RMNCH Plus A based on this conference, with the help of these international agencies, USAID, UNFPA, United Nations Population Fund, UNICEF, United Nations Children's Fund, and NIPI, that is Norway-India Partnership Initiative. So what is the strategy under RCH Phase 3? It is comprehensive care through 5 pillars, that is reproductive health, maternal health, neonatal health, child health, and adolescent health. So the plus component of RMNCH Plus is, plus focuses on adolescent health, linking MCH to reproductive health, adolescent, HIV, gender preconception, prenatal diagnostic techniques. So all other things other than mother and child care, that is before attaining pregnancy and then after the delivery of the child. So all those schemes and components were integrated under the RCH phase 3. Then linking home and community based services, these two are integrated, linked under phase 3. Linking referral and counter referral, referral means from PSC to CSC, from CSC to district hospital. Counter referral means from district hospital to CSC, CSC to PSC. So what is the aim? To reach maximum population in remotest corners of the country through continuum of services. Under this phase 3, 184 high priority districts were identified from 29 states where the health indices are poor or more concentration is given in these states. Then use of management tools and job aids were used. So what is the goal and target? Reduction of IMR to 25 per thousand by 2017. Reduction of MMR to 100 per 1 lakh by 2017. Reduction of TFR, total fertility rate, to 2.1 by 2017. What are the implementation strategies? Adolescent health program, adolescent nutrition and IFA supplementation, facility based adolescent reproductive and sexual health services, adolescent health clinics, information education services for adolescent sexual and reproductive health, menstrual hygiene scheme, preventive health checkup. And then what are other strategies? Care during pregnancy and childbirth, that is delivery of antenatal care package, skilled obstetric care, immediate essential newborn care, emergency obstetric and newborn care, postpartum continuum of care, postpartum IUCD, implementation of PCP and DT. Care of the newborn and child care, that is home-based care and prompt referral, facility-based care of sick newborn care. And Rashtriya Bal Swasthya Karyakram, RBSK. Care through reproductive years, that is community-based delivery of contraceptives, promotion of spacing methods like IUCD, sterilization methods promotion, that is tubectomy and vasectomy promotion, comprehensive care of sexually transmitted infection, reproductive tract infections. And then the concept of delivery points were given importance because National Rural Health Mission was also implemented under the same time. So under these delivery points, whichever centers are having more number of deliveries, they will be strengthened further. Like L1 delivery point means minimum 3 deliveries per month is happening there. L2 minimum 10 deliveries per month happening there. L3 minimum 20 to 50 deliveries per month happening there. Based on the case load, these centers will be strengthened. Scorecard was introduced under phase 3, where the health management system, information system based dashboard monitoring system was used and various indicators were devised to monitor the performance of the program. These indicators are based on life cycle approach. And then the last thing is the India Newborn Action Plan. So there is a paradigm shift in approach towards healthcare, keeping the newborn health at the center. So this is what we are talking about under the RCH phase 3. So that's all about the RCH program.
Meet you all in the next video. Until then, goodbye from Dr. Karthikeyan.